الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، We are in the صفات الحروف and we're in صفات لازمة. And within صفات لازمة we were speaking about what? صفات لها ضد. The صفات that have what? That have ضد. That have opposites. How many did we mention they were? Five. We previously took الهمس. We took what? الجهر. We also took what? الشدة. We took ال. So همس, the opposite of it is what? الجهر. الشدة, the opposite of it was what? الرخاوة. الاستعلاء, we took last lesson. What's the opposite of الاستعلاء? الاستفال. So today we're going to go into the opposite of what? الاستعلاء. The opposite of الاستعلاء, which is الاستفال. What does الاستفال mean? Remember the way we were doing it was what? We will explain it لغة واصطلاحا, and we will mention the حروف. That's how we were doing it, every single one of them. True or false? Alhamdulillah. Lughatan, what does the word al-istifal mean, lughatan? It means al-inkhifad. Inkhifad means when something goes what? Down. Inkhifad means when something goes down. Istilahan, what does it mean? It means inkhifadu hal-lisan. The tongue goes? When you say the kaf, how do you say amal kaf? The tongue goes what? انخفاضها اللسان, the tongue goes down إلى قاع الفم. What does قاع mean? قاع means the ending of the back of the tongue. Where the look at the إلى قاع الفم عند النطق بالحرف, when you utter the what? When you utter the letter. It comes from the قاع, the ending of the ending of the mouth. قاع means what? The ending of the الفم. الفم means what? Mouth. So انخفاض اللسان, the tongue goes down. The other ones, what was happening to the tongue? ارتفاع. What's the opposite of ارتفاع? انخفاض. ارتفاع means to go up. انخفاض means to go. Are you with me? When you say the lamb, what happens to the tongue? What happens to the tongue? ارتفاع, it goes up. صح brothers. انخفاض means the tongue goes down. Yeah, it's not from it. That's what I'm saying, it's opposite. ارتفاع means it goes up. انخفاض means it goes down. So لام, as a harf, the tongue goes what? It goes up. It means انخفاض اللسان, when the tongue goes up. لكن إلى قاع الفم. It's not just going up. When it goes up, what happens? It goes right down straight away. إلى قاع الفم, to the ending of the mouth. عند النطق بالحرف, when you're uttering the what? When you're uttering the letter. What are the letters for it?
All the letters except for the letter of
استعلاد. So every letter other than the letters of? استعلاد. What was the حروف الفرس? So it's خص ضغط قذ, right? How many letters were they?
Seven
letters. Naam, so anything other than those seven are what? Istifal. Hey? It's khussa dhagtin. Khussa saad. Khukha saad. Khussa dhagtin. Qil. So we finished istifal, right? We finished what? Al-istifal. We're now going to go into what? Al-itbaq. What does al-itbaq mean? It means iltisaq. Iltisaq means what? To stick to. We're going to see what sticking to stick. Istifal means inkhifadul lisani. It is the tongue going down ila qa'il fami, to the ending of the mouth. عند النطق بالحرف when you are uttering what? The letter. So it's انخفاض اللسان. The tongue is going down. إلى قاع الفم to the ending of what? The ending of the mouth. عند النطق بالحرف when you try to utter the what? When you try to utter the letter. What are the حروف for it? حروف الحروف الباقية. Other than the seven that was mentioned for استعلاء is what? Is استفال. Now we're going to go to الإطباق. We're going to go to what? الإطباق. What does إطباق mean? لغة. الالتصاق. What does التصاق mean? To stick to something. That's what it means in the language. What does it mean according to the scholars of the Quran, علماء القرآن, أهل القرآن? How do they define it? They say انطباق اللسان. انطباق means التصاق, right? So it means the tongue is sticking to الحنك الأعلى, the top roof of your mouth. It sticks to it. عند النطق بالحرف when you are trying to pronounce the letter. And they are what? صاد, ضاد, طاء, ضاء, مطبقة. مطبقة means what? Come from the word انطباق. Stuck. So صاد, صاد, ضاد, طاء, ضاء, مطبقة, أي ملتصقة. ملتصقة means what? To stick. So that's what Jazari says. وَصَادٌ ضَاءٌ. He says وَصَادٌ ضَادٌ طَاءٌ ضَاءٌ مُطْبَقَةٌ. Does that make sense? One more time. استفال means لغة الانخفاض, to go down. اصطلاحا it means انخفاضها اللسان. It's the tongue is going down إلى قاع الفم. It's going down where? To the ending of the mouth. عند النطق بالحرف when you are what? When you're uttering the word or the letter. What are the letters of al-istifal? So it is al-huruf al-baqiyah min al-isti'la. Jamil. What was the huruf al-isti'la then? We said khussa, khussa daghdin qidh. That's what we said, right? Those are the seven. Al-itbaq is what? Lughatan it means what? الالتصاق. اصطلاحا it means what? It means الانطباق. انطباق of what? It's the tongue is sticking to what? على الحنك الأعلى. What is حنك?
حنك الأعلى.
Yes. ها حنك. جميل. عند النطق بالحرف when you are what? When you are uttering the letter. What are the letters? What are the letters of what? Al-Itbaq. What are حروف الإطباق? وصاد ضاد ضاء مطبقة. جميل. What does مطبقة mean?
To stick to.
We're now going to go into what? We're going to go to Al-Infitah. Infitah is the opposite of what? Al-Itbaq. The axe of Al-Itbaq was what? Al-Infitah. Infitah is to what? Lughatan is al-ibti'ad, is to distance. It's to distance. Distance two things. What does the word al-infitah mean? It is ibti'ad, it's to distance. Okay? But the question here is, what is it that you distance? Istilahan it means al-infitah, it's to open. Or when you open something, what do? You distance one from the other, right? You make a distance between them. So it is al-infitah, it's to open ma bayna al-lisani, that which is between the tongue, and wal-hanak al-a'la, the hanak al-a'la, inda an-nutq bil-harf, when you pronounce the what? When you pronounce the letter.
Example,
qa. So we're going to come to it, inshallah ta'ala. Will you be able to because what was the itbaq? Iltisaq. The tongue and the ear, what? They stick together, right? Here, what's happening? You're doing the opposite. You're opening it. So it's infitah ma bayn al-lisani, that which is between the tongue, wal hanak al-a'la, the up. عند النطق بالحرف, when you are pronouncing the what? The letter. What are the حروف? What are the letters? الحروف الباقية, right? Ha. So it's the حروف الباقية from what? From the إطباق. It's any. What was the إطباق? صاد, ضاد, ضاء, ضاء, and what? مطبقة. So how many letters were they? صاد, ضاد, ضاء, ضاء. So we have how many? Four. Whatever is left from that four in the alphabet, the حروف الهجائية, is what? It's al-infitah. You bring space between your tongue and what? Yeah? Yeah. The حنك الأعلى is upper tongue. Those, anything, all of them. Al-idhlaq means what? Idhlaq is, it's hiddatul lisan wa talaqatuhu. What does hiddatul lisan mean? What did we say last time? The hidda of the lisan is? When we're talking about makharij al-huruf, what did we say it was? Look at your notes. What did we say? Hey, look at the picture. I'm going to look at your notes. What did we say it was? Ala kulli hal, hiddatul lisan means what? The lightness of the tongue. When the person is saying the huruf al-idhlaq, he's what? Talaqa, smiling, and he's what? It's light. Istilahan, what does it mean? It means khiffatul lisan. Far wa. It means the lightness of the tongue. Okay, pay attention. خِفَّةُ الْحُرُوفِ, the letters are what? They're light. وَسُرْعَةُ النُّطْقِ, and when you pronounce it, you pronounce it fast. لِخُرُوجِ, because they come out from what? لِخُرُوجِهِ مِنْ طَرَفِ اللِّسَانِ, it comes from the tip of the tongue. أو الشَّفَتَيْنِ, or it comes from the what? Your two lips. And the example for that is وَفِرَّ مِنْ لُبِّن, وَفِرَّ مِنْ لُبِّ الْحُرُوفِ الْمُذْلَقَةِ, وَفِرَّ, وَفِرَّ. So what are the letters? Those are the حروف. Those are the حروف. So it's waw, fa, ra, mim, noon, lam, and what? Ba. So there, how many? Sitatu ahruf. How many letters? Those are the six letters. Those are the what? Those are the six letters. We're going to do the last one and we will finish, inshallah ta'ala, sifat lazima. We're going to do the al-ismat, which is the opposite of what? Al-idhlaq. Are we all on the same page? But before I move on, I'll take some of the questions. Istilahan, it means khiffatul huruf, the lightness of the letters. Wa sur'atul nutq, and it's fast to pronounce it. Why is it, wait. Why is it fast to pronounce it? لِخُرُوجِهِ, because it's coming out from what? مِنْ طَرَفِ اللِّسَانِ, it's coming out from where? The tip of the tongue. أو الشَّفَتَيْنِ, or it's coming from the lips. One more time. خِفَّةُ الْحُرُوفِ, the letters are what? Light. وَسُرْعَةُ النُّطْقِ, and it's fast to pronounce it. Why? Why is it fast to pronounce it? How is it fast to pronounce it? لِخُرُوجِهِ, because it's coming out from where? مِنْ طَرَفِ اللِّسَانِ, the tip of the tongue, and أَوِ الشَّفَتَيْنِ, the two lips. And the example is وَفِرَّ مِنْ لُبِّن, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 7. We're going to now mention the what? The last one. وَخِتَامُهُ مِسْكِ. The last one, the best, and the last but not the least. Al-Ismat. Ismat is what? The opposite of what? Al-Idlaq. Al-Ismat is the opposite of what?
Al-Idlaq.
What does Al-Ismat mean, lughatan? In the Arabic language, what does the word Al-Ismat mean? It means Al-Man'u. What does Al-Man'u mean? It is to forbid. It is to prohibit. The word Al-Ismat, what does it mean? It means to prohibit. Al-Man'u. It means to what? Prohibit. Wastilahan, what does it technically mean? It means thiqalul huruf. The letters are heavy. Wasu'ubatun nutq. And it's hard to pronounce.
Heavy.
Lughatan, what does it mean in the Arabic language? What does the word al-ismat mean? It means al-man'u. It is to prohibit and forbid. Wastilahan, what does it technically mean? It's thiqalul huruf. Ama thiqalul harf. The letter is heavy. Wasu'uba, and it's hard. Su'uba means what?
It's hard to pronounce.
Hard. And nutq, to pronounce. Bihi.
Like slow.
It's hard to pronounce it. Ha. Likhuruji, because it's coming out from what? Ba'idan an tarafil lisan. It's coming far from what? Likhuruji. That's what it's meant to be. Lithiqal in nutqi. Likhuruji ha. Sahwa. Okay, pay attention. I did a mistake here. So let's read it again. Thiqal al-harf. The letters are what? Heavy. Wasu'uba. And it's hard. And nutqu bihi, to pronounce it. Likhurujiha, because it's coming out from what? Ba'idan, far. From where? Far from what? An tarafi lisani, the tip of the tongue. This one was what? Likhurujihi, from what? Min tarafi lisani. This was coming out from the tip of the tongue. Anything that comes from the tip of the tongue is what? It's easy and it's light. But here it's what? Ba'idan an taraf al-lisani. Wash-shafa. And it's also far from the what? The two lips. It doesn't come out from the lips. That's why it's hard. Does that make sense? So it's the opposite. This one's easy because it's coming out from where? The tip of the tongue and the two lips. This one here, it's hard to pronounce it. And it's heavy because it's coming out from other than the tip of the tongue and other than the lips. What are the letters of al-ismat? It is anything which is not wafirra min lubbin. Anything that's not those seven letters. It's what? Baqi al-huruf. Baqi huruf al-hija'iyya. It is the other remaining alphabetical letters that are not mentioned in al-idlaq. Okay? I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. We have finished. Walillahi alhamdu wal minna. What have we finished? So we finished sifat lazima. And we, mashallah, what did we mention? We mentioned the two opposites. So now we're going to mention the other side of what? Sifat lazima, which is what? La didda laha. We didn't mention la didda laha. That's what's left for us next lesson, inshallah ta'ala. We're going to do the seven. Bi-idhnillahi al-bari. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.